Patty, it's such a pleasure to be with you. And on behalf of the Academy Museum of Motion Pictures, I want to thank you for gifting the Richard Balzer collection to the museum. It's such an extraordinary collection.
Thank you so much. It's lovely to be with you. And it's an honor to have the opportunity to talk about the collection my late husband, Richard Balzer, collected for 40 years. And he developed it into a passion throughout the rest of his life.
And I know that many TCM fans are thoroughly familiar with the history of cinema, but they may not be familiar with this prehistory of cinema and the optical devices and toys that comprise the Richard Balzer collection. So could you talk to us about what these objects are and why they're important when we think about the history of cinema?
It's a very large collection. There are over 9,000 objects. The Academy overall has access to the entire collection. And, you know, there's a wonderful selection. Jessica Niebel, the curator, has made a wonderful selection of objects. A number of them are my favorites, and a few of them are my husband's favorites. I'm not sure if she knew that or if they just had similar taste.
What was it like for you as you were seeing more and more of these objects coming into your home?
Many, many, many of the objects in the collection are spectacularly beautiful. The craftsmanship, the hand painting, just really spectacular. But there are those that are quite plain. And often those would be the ones that my husband was most thrilled about from a historical perspective. And so he'd, you know, get something from a dealer, he'd unwrap it, he'd share it with me and say, what do you think? And I'd either say, oh my, that's absolutely exquisite, it's so beautiful. Or I'd say, that must have great historical significance, dear, because it was pretty plain. The bullseye lantern is quite a wonder to behold, though, to think that this was in active use so long ago. There are a number of objects from the 19th century, late 19th century, the Eiffel Tower lantern. It's a well-known but uncommon lantern to find. It's absolutely beautiful, painted glass and metal. And this was a child's lantern. Another favorite of mine is the triunial lantern, which is the large three-lens lantern. It's about 3 feet tall, and it's really spectacular. Just by looking at it, you get the wonder and the sense of it.
Patty, you're a member of the museum's board of trustees. You're one of the people who is working so hard with all of us to create this new museum and all of the experiences it will provide for people. What do you want most for folks to take away?
What I hope is that the museum is a gateway for the greater Los Angeles, and in fact, the world, to actually come in and learn about the industry, to learn about what's behind the films that they enjoy, the history, of course, and there just isn't a better place for it. It completes the arc of the narrative of the museum and the story of cinema.
We owe him a huge debt, and you as well, for gifting it to us.
You know, in addition to a fabulous place to put the collection, I've also gained a wonderful community of people in Los Angeles that I couldn't be more thrilled about. So it's a wonderful next chapter for the collection.